The NFL anthem controversy heating up yet again. Dallas Cowboys quarterback Dak Prescott not backing down after he received backlash for saying stadiums are not the proper venue for protests, even though he also said he supports the message coming from the protesting players. Jesse, you're a football fan. We know that Jerry Jones, the owner of the Cowboys, said, you know, the Cowboys policy is going to be to stand. The NFL then said, Jerry, we have a stand down agreement with the players. Let's not have any more comments. And now here comes Dak Prescott, his star quarterback.
I hate to say this about a cowboy, but I think he nailed it. It's the exact correct stance to take. All he's saying is that he respects the anthem and believes that that moment of 2 minutes at a football stadium is a time of national unity. And he says, I'm not going to disparage anybody that wants to kneel. That's their MO. And not to say that there's not a lot of social justice problems in this country that need to be addressed, and he'd like to address them. Just not during those 2 minutes of the anthem. And now he's getting backlash. I think D.L. Hughley said he only said this because he wanted to please his master, Jerry Jones, because he was the owner and he had to say this because he's under contract. I really dislike that. It seems like any time there's a black athlete who comes out against the liberal orthodoxy, they're attacked for having a different independent opinion. It happens all across the stratosphere with Clarence Thomas, Kanye West, Ben Carson. Whenever you voice an opinion aside from what the liberals want you to say, you're attacked as a race traitor, and I don't appreciate that, and I don't think Dak does either.
I think what D.L. Hughley said is similar to what we just said in the last block of Hillary Clinton saying that white suburban women, white women only voted for Trump because their husbands told them to. It's like, actually, you know what? Guess what? Newsflash, it's 2018, and everybody can think for themselves. I think what Dak Prescott did showed real leadership, and that's what quarterbacks do, right? They lead.
What do you think, Jedediah? Because in this moment, it's also the case that there's tremendous momentum among the NFL players to say, this is our moment to take a stand, to stand together, and to call attention. It's our moment, our platform for calling attention to social injustice, police brutality.
Yeah. I mean, and that may be true, but his statement was so non-controversial. I mean, that, I think that was why I was surprised, because I'm used to the mob going after people when they come out and they say something that really goes against the grain. But this guy was saying, I mean, even part of his quote was, I respect everybody and power to the people that kneel. This is what they believe in, and they should be able to kneel. So it was completely benign. Yeah. And still, you can't get away with even slightly saying something ever so different than what most people around you are saying without having the mob, particularly on Twitter and social media, with this becomes insane. This guy got completely bombarded. And I just think that if you can't have a nuanced opinion that's subtle like this and say, well, you know, I get where you're coming from, but you can't have a conversation at all, because that it may be the time and the moment to be doing this, but he's still a guy who's entitled to his opinion. And he said it so gently and so beautifully. Honestly, it was like this guy had media training. It was unbelievable. So I don't know what else you could do. I mean, he handled it beautifully.
So the other way to look at it, Greg, is Malcolm Jenkins, who plays for the Eagles, for Jesse's team, said that Jerry Jones is a bully and he's just trying to enforce his own orthodoxy on the players and not allow them, you know, their right to express discontent with social justice in the country.
I don't think, I think that's an evasive response to what is a clear perspective, which is you just don't protest at work. No one's stopping you from protesting and showing up. You can go to the police station, you can go to the park, you can make a sign, but you're here at work, and if you do that, you're going to be fired. That's, I don't protest here at work, even when I feel strongly about many things. Dak is, what I find interesting most about this story was when the media brought up the social media backlash, his response was kind of like, whatever. Yeah. And I think he knows the difference between real life, which is his family and his work, and this fake life, which is hysteria and the mob. And more people need, including the people around him, need to adopt that kind of perspective. However, listen, so the problem, the reason why this problem persists is two sides are talking past each other. It would be nice to have an actual meeting of the minds, not just a camera on Kaepernick and a camera on Trump. But the solution is always to have people come together and chat.
And if Dak went to Jerry Jones, the owner, and said, here's my charity, here's my cause, can you cut a check? I'm sure it'd be a pretty fat check from Jerry Jones.
All right. Well, how far is too far when taking the perfect social media picture? People pushing the limits for death-defying photos. That's next, right here on The Five.